Hello, my name is Aaron, and this is Daily Drivers, where we investigate whether or not various operating systems are seriously usable on a day-to-day basis. In my intro video to this series, I said that I wouldn't be dealing with Windows except for some edge cases. While that's mostly true, I still feel the need to do a video covering modern iterations of Windows, mostly to compare them to older versions and also to other operating systems. I don't suppose anyone really needs Windows explained to them. It's Microsoft's flagship OS used in something like 3/4 of all desktop PCs and around 1/4 of the servers on the internet. It was not the first graphical system, nor is it the longest lasting, but it is by far the most popular, at least on the desktop. As of this writing, Windows 10 is the current version, specifically 21H1, with most recent update released August 10th, 2021. Windows 11 was recently announced, but it won't be released for a while yet. Windows 10 runs on 32 and 64-bit x86 compatible processors, along with versions for ARM and ARM64 chips, probably meant for tablets, I suppose. Windows 11 is apparently limited to x86 64 and ARM 64 systems, but apparently it's going to be able to run on the Raspberry Pi, so that's kind of neat. Previous versions all ran on x86 and x86 64 machines, and various systems had builds for ARM, Itanium, Alpha MIPS, and or PowerPC chips. Note that the PowerPC builds of Windows won't run on PowerPC Macs. They're supposedly limited to select IBM PowerPC machines. I haven't tried running it on my G4, but I expect it wouldn't work. On the home user side of things, we have the Windows 9X line, which includes Windows 95, 98, and ME, or Millennium Edition. All non-NT versions of Windows are limited to 32-bit x86 processors. They can usually run on modern 64-bit chips in 32-bit mode, although sometimes patches are needed for them to run acceptably depending on your specific hardware. And they're limited to 4 gigs of RAM no matter what, with various systems having different actual limits. Before Windows 95, we had the original 16-bit versions of Windows, starting with Windows 1.0 way back in 1985, and culminating in Windows for Workgroups 3.11. Windows for Workgroups had some 32-bit code, but it was still a 16-bit system. There was also Windows 3.2, but that was limited to simplified Chinese and was really more of a bug fix rather than an actual full system upgrade. All 16-bit versions of Windows ran on top of DOS, making them graphical shells rather than full operating systems. Even the 9X line technically runs on top of DOS, although Microsoft went to some lengths to hide that, to the point that you can't really exit to DOS from Windows ME without some hackery. Also, the 9X line isn't completely 32-bit, it's actually a 16-32-bit hybrid. Requires a fully 32-bit processor, meaning 386 or newer, but a lot of the code is 16 bits under the hood, which sometimes makes for some interesting crashes. So, enough history. I'll almost certainly cover some of those older versions in their own episodes later, but for now, I'm talking about modern Windows, going no further back than Windows 8.1, because that's what Microsoft still officially supports. In short, modern versions of Windows are all good as daily drivers for all tasks. Yes, even 8.1. As long as your system has adequate hardware and is up to date, you can game, program, write, use the internet, watch movies, create media, or whatever else you want. Pretty much every piece of software in existence has a Windows version. It's what programmers write for. That's the good news. The not so good news is you need a relatively modern machine. A 1 GHz processor is the minimum required, but trust me, it won't work acceptably. I tried getting Windows 7 to work on my old 1 GHz Athlon, and it was awful. I can't believe that 8 or newer would be good on a similar system. 32-bit machines need a gig of RAM, while 64-bit machines need 2 gigs, with 4 gigs recommended for both. But if you only have the minimum, don't expect to be able to do much of anything. Windows 8 requires 16 gigs of hard drive space, or 20 gigs for 64-bit, while recent versions of Windows 10 need 32 gigs. But again, if you only have the minimum, you won't be able to do much. They also require a video card that supports DirectX 9, but that apparently dates back like 20 years, so it really shouldn't be a problem in an otherwise modern machine. Also, before recent builds of Windows 10, there was no default package manager for Windows. Windows 8, I think, introduced an app store, but believe me, it's lacking. And I know nothing about the recently introduced package manager, so I can't really speak to how good it is or is not. One thing to bear in mind when using Windows is that it is absolutely imperative that you keep your system up to date, at least with security updates. Windows is notorious for being a bug-ridden security creator, and if you don't keep on top of things, you will end up with a biohazard box. Antivirus programs are a must. If you don't get a third-party app, then you need to leave the built-in Windows Defender running. And it's not very good, but it's better than nothing. Also, a firewall isn't a bad idea either. So, to summarize, Windows is a good daily driver, as long as your machine isn't old enough to vote. It's still the most used desktop OS on the planet, and I don't really see that changing anytime soon. And that wraps things up for this episode. Stay tuned for the next episode, where I'll be covering modern Mac OS. If you liked this video, please thumb it up. If you didn't, well, thumb it down, whatever. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments section, and I'll get around to answering them eventually, I swear. I'm always interested in suggestions on what OSs to cover. If you want to see me cover a particular OS, leave your suggestion in the comments section, and I'll see what I can do. My name is Eric, and thanks for watching this episode of Daily Drivers.